That was a 20-year-old Saquon Barkley cleaning 405 pounds. This happened when he was still playing college football at Penn State. Not to mention that he did this with pretty inefficient technique and probably very little instruction on Olympic lifting. He just has brute strength and top-tier explosiveness. College football players are freak athletes, and the ones who make it to the NFL are the cream of the crop. They are genetic anomalies with the type of strength and speed most of us can't even imagine possessing. There are a lot of people who think that if you were to take an NFL player, specifically one with a similar physique to a CrossFit athlete, that they would dominate the field at the CrossFit games if given the chance. With absolutely no additional training, it's clear Saquon Barkley would win or be in the top three of almost every strength event at the CrossFit Games with ease. His strength is light years ahead of all of the CrossFit Games athletes. But what if that strength event had a slightly mixed element to it, like a run clean ladder, something we saw at the 2021 CrossFit Games? Yes, Saquon is significantly stronger than the field, but how would his strength fare if it was mixed with endurance? Some of these are the strength events at the CrossFit Games and can last as long as a few minutes, longer than any play in football ever lasts. How would he do? Now let's take it further and consider how you think he might do on a marathon row, 5K run, or 40-minute bike ride at max level intensities. What about 15 events across 4 days? Now, what if you gave someone like Saquon a few years to train for the CrossFit Games? Someone of his athletic prowess could pretty easily pick up all of the skilled movements of CrossFit and learn how to clean and snatch more efficiently. He could drastically improve his endurance, something that is typically easier to develop and maintain compared to strength, and it's also low-hanging fruit for him because it's probably something he's never really worked on because there was no need. But still, strength and endurance are only part of the puzzle. We regularly see CrossFit athletes who are good at just about everything in CrossFit get exposed for some weird weakness they have. Whether it's high volume, upper body pulling, overhead shoulder stability, grip endurance, swimming, or whatever else, and some can't seem to get better at that one specific thing, and it handicaps them year after year, leaving points on the table during these events. I'm sure these athletes are working on these weaknesses year after year, but some weaknesses aren't as easy to address for some people. Who knows what Saquon's athletic profile would look like in these things? You can't make the assumption that just because he's insanely powerful, that he would also have good upper body pulling endurance, grip endurance, overhead shoulder stability, and so forth. For example, on the inverse of this, Justin Medeiros, the 2x CrossFit Games champion, is not as strong as the rest of the CrossFit Games field when it comes to overhead pressing, but he has the best overhead shoulder stability in the game. In the 2020 CrossFit total, there was a max strict press. Justin only hit 175 pounds. The other four competitors at the CrossFit Games that year had an average of 207 pounds. But in the events where pressing strength is not the focus, but rather shoulder stability, Justin is always on top. Push jerks, handstand walks, overhead walking lunges, we consistently see Justin winning these events. I say all of this about Justin to emphasize the point that you cannot make assumptions about an athlete's overall profile just based off of a few lifts. And while endurance can be developed in a reasonable amount of time, this is actually still where Saquon would get hung up. Even with numerous hours of work, an athlete like Saquon still wouldn't be able to get his endurance to the level of a top CrossFit Games athlete. Let me explain. You see, there are two groups of muscle fiber types that humans have. This is a pretty complex system, but I will break it down as simply as possible for the sake of time. There are fast twitch muscle fibers, which are capable of producing a lot of power in a short amount of time, but tire out very quickly. And then there are slow twitch muscle fibers. These are not capable of producing as much power, but do not tire out as quickly and recover faster than the fast twitch group. The reason I bring up muscle fiber types is because this is an extreme determinant of your performance in specific athletic endeavors. The average person has about a 50-50 ratio of slow twitch and fast twitch muscle fibers. Extremely elite long distance runners can have a ratio of about 80% slow twitch and 20% fast twitch. And elite sprint athletes fall on the inverse of that, having about 20% slow twitch and 80% fast twitch. This is where someone like Saquon Barkley and other football players land. In CrossFit, there are max lifts, long runs, and everything in between. To excel, an athlete would want to have a mix of muscle fiber types more in the middle of this spectrum. Someone like Saquon Barkley simply doesn't have the genetic tools to be able to have the endurance of someone like Matt Fraser, as most of his muscle fibers are fast twitch fibers that tire out quickly, hence his extreme explosiveness. If you believe that someone like Saquon Barkley, an athlete on one extreme end of the human spectrum, could become the most well-rounded athlete on the planet, then do you also think that Eliud Kipchoge, the man with a sub 2-hour marathon, could do well in CrossFit also? He would win all the endurance events and he would just need to improve his strength, right? This argument of these extremely explosive athletes in the NFL being able to beat CrossFit Games athletes has never made sense to me. They are specialized individuals, not only in their training, but in their genetics as well. I do not want to seem like I'm downplaying the greatness of these athletes, but rather highlight the fact that the CrossFit Games athletes are extremely specialized athletes as well, only their specialty is being a jack of all trades. But let's stop with all these hypotheticals and hypotheses. We already have an athlete like Saquon competing at the CrossFit Games. That was a video of Gi cleaning 415 pounds at 20 years old. Looks similar at all? Gi dominates every heavy lifting event at the CrossFit Games so easily it looks like he's using fake weights. Racking up enough points in the strength and sprint events to place in the top 10 at the CrossFit Games 2 years in a row, 2021 and 2022. But he can't quite crack into that top tier of athletes at the Games. He consistently places extremely high on some events and all the way towards the bottom on others, showing just how specialized he is. Despite the fact that he's spent the last few years working with the best endurance coaches in the world who have made champion after champion after champion in CrossFit. And still, this year, he couldn't do well enough in the endurance events to qualify for the CrossFit Games out of the South America semifinal. While I don't disagree that someone like Saquon Barkley would do well, I do not think they would do as well as most people believe. He could win strength events with ease. He could definitely improve his endurance, but to what point, I don't know. Maybe ask Gi how difficult it is for an athlete like this to improve endurance. Saquon could win some events at the CrossFit Games, but could he even make it? He is even more specialized than someone like Gi and wouldn't have the advantage of being in what is for now a second tier region in terms of strength of field like Gi does with South America. And finally, if an athlete like Saquon were able to win the CrossFit Games, why haven't they? Not him specifically, but there are tons and tons of athletes who played football at the highest levels of college who may have just missed out on playing football professionally. Some of these guys are just as much of a beast in terms of strength and explosiveness. You're telling me they don't want to make hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars a year? There is a reason that out of millions of kids playing football, Saquon is the one in the NFL. He was quite literally made for it. The guys at the top of the CrossFit Games field are made for this. They are the most well-rounded athletes on the planet.